RACESports.com. I'm Grant Boone with head men's basketball coach Joe Golding. His team tonight defeats Arlington Baptist 90-39. And, Coach, we were talking before the game. It's not about the opponent in these games against non-D1s. It's about how you play. Well, you held them scoreless for the first 10.5 minutes of the game. It was 18-0. That doesn't happen without intentionality on defense, does it?
Yeah, that was a really good job by our staff of getting our guys prepared defensively. Obviously, Coach Tanner does a great job with our team, and I was real impressed with some things that happened defensively early on. We just have to be more consistent with that as the game goes on. I think there were times as the game went on that we weren't as consistent. They beat us in a couple four-minute games in the second half. We got sloppy defensively, and then the whole game offensively, we never got in rhythm, you know. And so credit Arlington Baptist to that. I think you and I talked at radio after the game. There's going to be some really good things that we did tonight, and there's some things that we got to clean up and get a lot better at. But overall, we got the opportunity for a lot of guys to get minutes. It's, you know, we've had two scrimmages now. We had a chance to get in front of the lights, in front of people in the crowd at home, and obviously now tape doesn't lie. We'll get in the film room and clean some stuff up.
Colton Cole got the start tonight, and a 7-footer against a non-D1. You're going to say he's going to have an advantage, but you still have to do it. And he was 10 of 13 from the field. It was solid, 21 points.
Yeah, I'll say this. He's had a great summer.
Yeah,
he's had a great fall. He's played really well in both scrimmages, and he played well tonight. I was proud of him. He did exactly what he should do tonight. You know, against an opponent like that, he should go 10 of 13 from the floor. That's what he's been doing all summer and all fall, and we need him to continue to do that. We didn't throw him the ball enough. You know, when people play straight behind him, we got to do a better job of pounding the basketball in there. You know, I think we got bored at times of throwing the ball in there, and so if that's how teams are going to play us, then we have to do a better job with our guards of getting the basketball. I think he took 13 shots, like you just said. He probably should 30 by the time we look at tape. And so, again, that's what these games are for, and that's tape. But I'm proud of Colton. He still could get a lot better. There's still things that he knows that he's got to get better at communicating and talking on the defensive side of the floor. But good start for him.
What do you think about your new guys, including your freshman Arion Simmons?
I thought Makai was really good defensively tonight with the eye test. I haven't watched tape yet. He obviously didn't make a shot, but that's okay. We know he can score the basketball, but I thought he did some really good things. We had him as a get-back guy, and he actually went. We switched him to the glass there late in the second half. I thought he did a good job. We need to get him going to the glass more. He had some good cuts. I thought Arion is doing well. You know, we're continuing to push Arion. He's the only freshman on our team, so it's difficult for him at times. But that's the first time he got game action with it wearing the uniform, so he'll get better. He just has to continue to, you know, the more minutes he plays, the better conditioned he'll get, and he's going to be a really good player for us. Yeah. Reggie Miller, I thought he's been great for two scrimmages. He was good again tonight. The one thing him and Damian have done a great job early in the year for us is taking care of the basketball, and so
one turnover in the second half tonight.
Yeah, you know, and again, we only turned it over 7 times, so that's been pretty consistent now with us through two scrimmages and now this game. We got to take care of the basketball. I think we had 20 assists.
Corian Mason got the start.
Yeah, Corian got the start. He's been playing really well. We talked before the game. You know, obviously very well coached in junior college. Also played Division II basketball his freshman year. So he's going to be a good player for us. We just got to continue to push him and challenge him. He can be. I think he can be an elite defender in our conference. And so when you have him and Ricks on the wings, and then you have Damian and Reggie up front, it all starts right there. And we have to continue to challenge those guys. But those guys got a lot of minutes. We obviously didn't play Ricks and Joe a lot. It is what it is. You know, they've earned the right to play 15 minutes in a game like this. They did their job early. Obviously turning the page to Drexel, they'll be challenged.
Drexel from the Colonial Athletic Association. They played Temple tonight, lost a back-and-forth game 70-62. That's a really good league that maybe a lot of folks in Texas don't watch a whole lot, and Drexel's talented.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, anytime you go on the road early in the year, you're going to get tested. I'm excited. I'm excited to see how our guys respond. You know, Coach Spiker did a great job, I think, at Army before he came to Drexel. This is his fourth year. I think they have 10 or 11 guys back off of last year's team. They had a couple guys hurt that they expected a lot out of. They're going to be really good, really, really good. And so we have our work cut out for us. We got 4 days here to prepare. It'll be the first time that we've actually prepared for 4 days and scouts and film work and travel and getting in an airplane and hotel. Everything will be a new experience for some of those guys. So we got to handle it the right way. Hopefully we have good leadership in the locker room, and we're going to have to play our best to even be, you know, to be in the game late, I would assume. So hopefully we're ready to go.
Your good buddy Tommy Morris said you got to win 28 since you only won 27 last year. There's one tonight, right?
There's one. That's absolutely we got a lot of work to do. But Tommy's been great for our program, and
it was a great night tonight. Yeah, was it seeing the banner?
I'll tell you what, you and I talked about getting crowds involved and getting students involved. I thought it was a great opening crowd for the first game. So if we can continue to build on that, we obviously going to Drexel, but we have a big home game. A week and a half away, from here with Pepperdine. It's a big day. We got volleyball, I think football, and then a basketball game. So just got to continue to build our crowds as we get going here. But very appreciative, I know our guys are, of the fans and for them coming to watch us play.
ACU wins 90-39. They're at Drexel up in Philadelphia for a 1 o'clock tip-off on Sunday Central Time. We'll have the broadcast on 98.1 FM, The Ticket.